ang tahanan ng Panginoon. Sama-sama pagtitipon sa lambanan ng Panginoon. Tayo magdalo, tayo magsaya, tayo ng buon, tunay ang ganda. Sama-sama tutunguhin ang tahanan ng Panginoon. Sama-sama pagtitipon sa lambanan ng Panginoon.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My beloved brothers and sisters, we celebrate today the solemnity of the dedication of our cathedral, our mother church. We remember today how God has been gracious to make this place a place we can call His home, a place where we can always encounter Him through the word proclaimed to us and through the Eucharist shared to all of us. We ask the Lord that He may also touch our lives and our hearts, make us holy, and our lives dedicated for His greater glory. So as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us humbly acknowledge our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. You raise the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You bring light and hope to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Gloria in excelsis Deo.
Let us pray. O God, who year by year renew for us the day when this your holy temple was consecrated, hear the prayers of your people, and grant that in this place, for you there may always be pure worship, and for us, fullness of redemption. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. The angel brought me back to the entrance of the temple, and I saw water flowing out from beneath the threshold of the temple toward the east, for the facade of the temple was toward the east. The water flowed down from the southern side of the temple, south of the altar. He led me outside by the north gate and around to the outer gate facing the east, where I saw water trickling from the southern side. He said to me, "This water flows into the eastern district down upon the Araba and empties into the sea the salt waters which make it fresh. Wherever the river flows, every sort of living creature that can multiply shall live, and there shall be abundant fish. For wherever this water comes, the sea shall be made fresh. Along both banks of the river, fruit trees of every kind shall grow. Their leaves shall not fade, nor their fruit fail. Every month they shall bear fresh fruit, for they shall be watered by the flow from the sanctuary. Their fruit shall serve for food, and their leaves for medicine." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The waters of the river gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High.
The waters of the river gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High.
God is our refuge and our strength, an ever-present help in distress. Therefore, we fear not, though the earth may be shaken and mountains plunge into the depths of the sea.
The waters of the river gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High.
There is a stream whose runlets gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High. God is in its midst. It shall not be disturbed. God will help it at the break of dawn.
The waters of the river gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High.
The Lord of hosts is with us. Our stronghold is the God of Jacob. Come, behold the deeds of the Lord, the astounding things he has wrought on earth.
The waters of the river gladden the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, you are God's building. According to the grace of God given to me, like a wise master builder, I laid a foundation, and another is building upon it. But each one must be careful how he builds upon it, for no one lay a foundation other than the one that is there, namely, Jesus Christ. Do you not know that you are the temple of God and that the Spirit of God dwells in you? If anyone destroy God's temple, God will destroy that person, for the temple of God, which you are, is holy. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand.
I have chosen and sanctified this house, says the Lord, that my name may remain in it for all time.
Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Since the Passover of the Jews was near, Jesus went up to Jerusalem. He found in the temple area those who sold oxen, sheep, and doves, as well as the money changers seated there. He made a whip out of cords and drove them all out of the temple area with the sheep and oxen, and spilled the coins of the money changers and overturned their tables. And to those who sold doves, he said, "Take these out of here and stop making my father's house a marketplace." His disciples recalled the words of Scripture, "Zeal for your house will consume me." At this the Jews answered and said to him, "What sign can you show us for doing this?" Jesus answered and said to them, "Destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up." The Jews said, "This temple has been under construction for 46 years, and you will raise it up in 3 days." But he was speaking about the temple of his body. Therefore, when he was raised from the dead, his disciples remembered that he had said this, and they came to believe the Scripture and the word Jesus had spoken. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters. Happy Fiesta po muli sa inyo as we remember the dedication of our Mother Church, the Manila Cathedral. It is also again our Fiesta. Pangatlong araw na po nating nagbabatian ng Happy Fiesta. Pakainin nyo naman kami ni Monsignor Rolly. We remember today how this church was made holy, and as it is the word dedicated for the glory of God and for all of us to be made holy. I suppose not all of us would witness a rite of dedicating a church. Meron po ba dito sa inyo yung naka-attend 6 years ago when this altar was dedicated according to the rites of the Second Vatican Council? Maliban po siguro sa mga servants, no? Meron po ba dito sa mga faithful natin? It was dedicated or presided rather by our former Archbishop Cardinal Chito Tagle. Hindi man po palaging may bagong simbahan at may dedication ng simbahan, and should you wish to hear that a parish will be dedicated, I hope you'll be there to witness it. Napakaganda po nung rito ng pagtatalaga ng isang simbahan. We use the word dedication in the celebration. And as the church is sprinkled with water, the saints are called out when the bishop prays the prayer of consecration, when the altar and the walls are poured with chrism, when incense is fused all over the church, when the altar is decorated, and for the very first time, the Eucharist will be offered at that newly dedicated altar, we see how it is really dedicated when this building is dedicated for God and how this place is now made holy for God. And it is a beautiful reminder for us, as this cathedral was made holy by the rites of this dedication, this is made holy and is dedicated for God. This is a good gift for us, all of us, the living temple. St. Paul said in our second reading, is also continuously made holy and dedicated for God. Kung ang lugar na ito ay itinalaga para sa mas lalong ikapupuri ng Diyos, tayo din ay itinatalaga ng Diyos. Kaya po huwag tayong magulat kung minsan tila inaalis ni Jesus ang anumang mga bagay na hindi po nagpapabanal sa atin. We've heard how he threw out the mess at his father's house. One significant place for Christ when he can solemnly be with God. And now it turned out to be a marketplace. And this marketplace will also be true because in our hearts, there lie sins, our scandals, our dirt. As I've said yesterday, what would make us ugly and lifeless? As we remember the dedication of our mother church, we also remember how at every day that you are here to pray, how at every celebration you celebrate with us the Holy Eucharist, we are reminded that who we are will always be for God, made holy by God, and loved by God. The place is not only dedicated to God, but all of us, His loving children, will always be made holy and loved by this gracious God in our lives.
Please stand.
Let us profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
As we celebrate the dedication of our Mother Church, the Manila Cathedral,
let us bring our prayers to the Father, who had called us to be living stones. In our great need, let us say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Holy Church in every place will offer worthy and reverent worship. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all gathered by God in this church may find grace and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who care for the sacristy and maintenance and cleaning of this church will persevere in their service. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may always revere and respect every sanctuary of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the generous support of our benefactors may find their reward in the Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all the departed may enjoy the eternal light and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray in silence for our own intentions, as we lift up to the Lord all of the intentions offered in this Mass, our prayers for one another, for all of us, the Manila Cathedral community, our beloved staff, servants, pastors who have served the Manila Cathedral, those who have generously shared their time, talent, and treasure to maintain the beauty of this cathedral and the sublime and reverent worship of this cathedral, that they may always grow in God's grace and live holy lives. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Holy Lord and Father, as we celebrate the anniversary of the dedication of this church, grant the petitions of the community you have gathered once more at the altar. This we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Pray, beloved brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Recalling the day when you were pleased to fill your house with glory and holiness, O Lord, we pray that you may make of us a sacrificial offering always acceptable to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in this visible house that you have let us build, and where you never cease to show favor to the family on pilgrimage to you in this place, you wonderfully manifest and accomplish the mystery of your communion with us. Here you build up for yourself the temple that we are, and cause your church, spread throughout the world, to grow even ever more and more as the Lord's own body, till she reaches her fullness in the vision of peace, the heavenly city of Jerusalem. And so with the countless ranks of the blessed, in the temple of your glory we praise you, we bless you, and proclaim your greatness as we acclaim.
Panginoong Diyos ng mga hukbo, napupudlo ang langit at lupa ng kadakilaan mo. Hosana, hosana sa kaitaasan. Hosana, hosana sa kaitaasan. Pinagpala ang kaparirito sa pala ng Panginoon. Sana o sana sa kaitaasan. Sana o sana sa kaitaasan. Sana o sana sa kaitaasan. Hosana, hosana, sa kaitaasan.
Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, the Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. As children of our loving Father, we call on him as Christ taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, But deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all the distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
sakramentong banal na kahangama. Papurihan natin at lahat ng bansa, o sakramentong banal na kahangama. Tanggapin natin buhay niya at biyaya.
Please stand.
Let us pray. May the people consecrated to you, O Lord, we pray, receive the fruits and joy of your blessing, that the festive homage that have offered you today in the body may redound upon them as a spiritual gift, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As we are celebrating today the solemnity of the dedication of our Manila Cathedral, our Mother Church, it is a yearly privilege and a blessing that the faithful will be able to kiss the altar of the cathedral. You know that at every Mass, the only ones who are kissing the altar are the ordained, the bishops, the priests, and the deacons. And at every time we remember the dedication of the cathedral, we are extending this yearly privilege to the faithful gathered, that as we remember the dedication of this church, you are also pleased to be invited to kiss and venerate the altar. Kaya po, just give us the time to prepare the altar after the Mass so that you can queue up from your right. Dito po kayo aakyat so that you can venerate and kiss the altar as a sign of our celebration and solemn pledge this dedication anniversary of our cathedral. Come Sunday, we will be beginning our 9 days preparation for Christmas, our Misa de Aguinaldo. Our Masses during evenings is at 8 p.m. and every morning at 4:30. We wish to invite all of you for these days of preparation as we headlong to our celebration of Christmas. At muli po, sa ngalan po ni Monsignor Rolly, at ang buong Manila Cathedral staff and servants, we wish to extend our greetings to you, once more a happy fiesta, and our gratitude for your generosity, presence, and support these past days and even today. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. May God, the Lord of heaven and earth, who has gathered you today in memory of the dedication of this church, make you abound in heavenly blessings forever and ever.
Amen.
And may he who has willed that all his scattered children be gathered together in his Son, grant that you may become his temple and the dwelling place of the Holy Spirit forever and ever.
Amen.
Thus may you be made thoroughly clean, so that God may dwell within you, and you may possess with all the saints the inheritance of eternal happiness, now and forever.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go forth to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.